Hello everyone, I'm Purnima and once again I'm back with you to continue with the lesson The Rat Trap. As I told you, this lesson is based on philosophy as well as it is also very entertaining. Now let's see what happened. Till now I've told you a rat trap seller was there. He used to sell rat trap, but that profession was not able to fulfill his needs. For his survival he needs more money. So what he used to do? He used to do begging, and even after begging, if he was not satisfied, that means he never used to get enough money, he used to do thievery also. So in this way he was surviving. These were the source of his survival. Now and that rat trap seller, he was different from the other people, and he was a man with a long beard, dirty, ragged, and with a bunch of rat traps dangling on his chest. Now he did not like the people who were living happily in the world. In fact, he was jealous with them for two reasons. One, everybody was harsh to him. Second, nobody was his friend. Nobody supported him. Nobody helped him. And his life, his own life, has become the life of a vagabond. Vagabond means he did not have any family, friends, job, and anyhow, his life was passing like that. Though definitely used to work hard. It is not that he used to sit ideal. He was working hard. He was going to the different factories, different store, and collected the wires, and then he used to make rat trap by himself. He used to sell them. So, but then also he was not satisfied with the world around him, and one day he was going and thinking that the whole world is a rat trap. He started thinking, in fact, he started comparing the whole world as a rat trap. And children, when he thought this thing, he got unusual joy to think ill of the world, because there was a hatred in his heart against the mankind. He was not happy with any man. Nobody helped him. Nobody spoke him properly. Nobody was affectionate to him. Everybody was harsh to him. So that for this feeling of hatred was there. And he used to feel happy when he used to think that this whole world is a rat trap. And we, the human beings, we are running inside that rat trap. And we are running to have our bats. We are the rats and we are running to have our bats. Now children, bats here, he's indicating to the richness, to the jewelries, good job, good house, okay, good shelter, good home. So all this thing is a bat for human being. We all are running for a comfortable and for worldly pleasure, and we get this thing, and finally, after enjoying for some time only, we die. So this whole world is compared, and he feels very happy when he feels that at last we all die. Our life come to an end. Now once he was going and he had met a peddler. Now he got a good hospitality from the peddler, and when that peddler was going, and he went to the old crofter house. His house was small, nobody was there in the house, and he asked for the shelter. He was happy that that crofter has given not only shelter but food, and he played cards with him. In fact, he had trust him so much, he had a trust on the peddler that he shared all his secret to him. But the peddler was a wicked person.
he took advantage of his secret. And what he did? When he went out to milk his cow, the crofter, the old crofter, the peddler, he came from the backside of the window. He took all his currency, all his money which he had saved till now, he took it away. So how much money he had? 30. Yes, he had a 30 kronor. So the old man was very much just as generous with his confidence as with his porridge and tobacco. He gave him all his very personal information he imparted to the guest. Now he even told him and showed him the money where he kept his money. So he had so much friend, he thought ki this man, he will not ditch him, he will be loyal to him. That's why he shared all his secret about his money, where he kept it, how much he got it. Okay, this all he kept for himself. Now he stole it and he is running towards the forest. And when he goes towards the forest, he is very much dead tired. First thing he realizes that he is moving to the place again and again. And he is so tired, he knew that he will never come out from the forest. So he knew that he cannot escape now. He can never go out from the forest. 30 knor was the bait for him, which took him to the forest. And here forest is compared to the rat trap. So now he was also entangled with that 30 kronor, and now his life was also in danger. And he is taking those 30 kronor as a bet, and the rat trap here is the forest, and he is going and searching from the way, but till now he did not get any route or the way to move outside. He was very much tired. He slept at one place. So he just threw his body on the ground. That means he fell on the ground. And he was so tired that he started sleeping. Then suddenly he heard thumping sound, which proved that some people are around. This sound gave him some hope, and he staggered toward the place from where the sound was coming. And when he heard this, he was very happy. He was very hopeful. He was thinking, now he can save his life. So what he did? He started moving. He staggered towards the place from where the sound was coming. Well, he searched, and finally he reached to the same place where that crofter used to work. Now children, he reached to the same place, see, remember, where that crofter used to work. The crofter, who had given him shelter at night in his house. He reached to the mill. There was a lot of sound around. There was sound of nature, waterfall. Now children, at the same time, he reached to that place from where sound was coming. He reached to the place where he felt ki water is there. There is a waterfall. And there were different sound of nature was coming. Okay, lot was reached to the mill. There was a lot of sound around. Now, Iron Master looked casually at the intruder. Now the intruder, he went to the Iron Master. Okay, he looked casually at the intruder. He was busy doing something, and he knew that this type of fellow generally comes and they take shelter at night. So he did not care so much for him. His looks was also similar to the other stranger, like other stranger. He was also looking to him, at him, and his look, whose look, the look of the rat trapper, it was also similar to the other stranger. at the meal. So it was not very unusual for him. So the blacksmith did not pay any attention to him. The rat trap seller asked his permission to give shelter there. So he, without asking anything, without welcoming him, nodded his head to give his consent to stay there at night. Now, children, finally, the rat trap seller, he asked that can he stay there at night, and he also gave his consent. He nodded his head to tell him that he can stay in that cottage. He can stay for the whole night, and then he can move. And then he did not pay any attention to him. The rat trap seller asked his permission to give shelter there. So he, without asking anything, without welcoming him, nodded his head to give his consent to stay at night. Now, children, the turning point comes. Here the turning point of the story comes. Now, the owner of the iron mill was a very prominent man. Prominent. He was a very important person and very famous person. Ambitious. He was a very ambitious man. He wanted to ship his good. What was his good? Iron. He wanted to sell it to the market abroad. So he came to inspect iron mills very often. Now, children, he wanted to export the iron ore. And at that time, I told you this story was written when Sweden was the center place of the iron ore. So he was the iron of that place. And what his business was, he used to export this iron ore to the other countries. And he wanted to export the best quality of iron ore so that his customer should not leave him. So the rat trap asked his permission to give shelter there. So he, without asking, the owner of the iron mill was very prominent man, very ambitious. He wanted to ship good iron to the market, but he came to inspect iron mill very often. And so for that, he wanted to come to the iron mill very often. He used to look everything. Now, one day by chance, he also came. He looked at the man who was lying close to the furnace. Now, this man, this rat trapper, he was so tired, and it was winter time also. He slept near the furnace. So he was lying close to the furnace, and because it was a winter night, his clothes were damp because of the dew. And since he was lying close to the furnace, steam started coming out from his clothes or rags. The iron of the iron mill was not like the other. He wanted to see who that man was. Now, children, the owner of the iron mill, he was a person who used to be very carefully handle each and everything. So, and when he looked at him, he became alert. He became careful, and he went to him. At that time, he was sleeping. Now, he pulled the rat from his face. He removed the hat from his face. Now, that hat had covered his face. In fact, he put the hat on his face and slept. So, but that the owner of the iron mill, when he came, he removed the hat from his face to see that who that person is and why he is lying near the furnace. Now, when the iron mill master saw him, so shocked to see that the man, his face resembles a person to whom he knew very well. He saw the man and he took him for Nils Olifoff. So, children, when he looked at the face, When he pulled the hat, he looked at the face. He was surprised. That face was resembling the face of Nils Olifoff. Nils Olifoff was a officer when he was there. Then this Nils Olifoff, he was a captain in the army. And at that time, even this Iron Master, he was also working in the army. But due to some reason, he had taken voluntary retirement and now he was not working. He left army due to some reason. Now, when he had removed the hat from his face, he was surprised. He came to know that this man, he is a Nils Olifoff. So till here I have told you this part. Now let's see what happened. We will read. I will be doing the explanation from here. Now, so children, he is mistook. He imagined that rat sailor is his old friend Nils Olof. And he is surprised at how shabby he is looking. Earlier he was a captain in the army. He used to dress so very properly. With all his etiquettes, he used to sit and stand with him. The man with the rat traps had never before seen the Iron Master at Ramjo's and did not even know what his name was. Now children, when he removed the hat from his face, the old man, he mistook the man for his old acquaintance. He thinks that he is old comrade of him. Now, but the red trap seller was not very much as amazed, as he knew that he is not Nils Olof. Now children, he started calling by that name, that Iron Man seller, the master of the iron mill. But he knew that he is not Nils Olof, but he was so clever that he did not said this thing to him. He did not told this thing to him till now, that he is not Nils Olof. Now he agrees. Now let's hear. The man with the rat trap had never before seen the Iron Master at Ramjo's and did not even know what his name was. Now children, he was surprised at why this Iron Man master had took him for Nils Olof, his old comrade, his old friend when they were in the army. And this Nils Olof, he was a officer, he was a captain in the army. The man with the rat trap had never before seen the Iron Master at Ramjo's and did not even know what his name was. Now children, and here that man, the rat trap sailor, he was not knowing that who this man is, why he is forcing to come in his house. And he did not even know what his name was. He was not knowing the simple thing. Till now he was not aware of the name of that man. But it occurred to him that if the fine gentleman thought he was an old acquaintance, he might perhaps throw him a couple of kronor. So children, the man with the rat traps had never before seen the Iron Master at Ramjo's and did not even know that what his name was. Now children, the man, the rat trap seller, he had never seen that Iron Master before, and he was not knowing his name. So it occurred to him that if the fine gentleman thought he was an old acquaintance, he might perhaps throw him a couple of kroner. Therefore, he did not want to undeceive him all once. Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. Now, children, now here the Iron Man meets. He is still thinking that he is his old friend, his old buddy, his old comrade, Nils Olof. But Nils Olof knew that he is not the person to whom he is thinking. He is very clever. Till now he had not disclosed his identity. He told ki he will throw him some couple of kroner, and if the fine gentleman thought he was an old acquaintance, he might perhaps throw him a couple of kroner. Therefore, he did not want to underestimate him all at once. Now, children, he thought, this man, if he will know me, that if he will know me as his friend, he will surely help him. He will surely give him some kroner. But something happened to him. Some change was going on him. For the first time, he did not wanted to have the kroners. Now, yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me. You should not have resigned from the regiment. Now, children, once again, he believed, the Iron Man master believed that he is his old friend, okay, and he has resigned from the army, so he is giving him advice. See, you should not have resigned from the army. What, that was a mistake. If only I had still been in the service at the time, it never would have happened. And now, of course, you will come home with me. Now, children, what he is telling? He is telling, he agrees to the Iron Master that he is Neil's old off. He thought it's better to admit the that things he is not, he only wanted that he should remember him as Neil Oldorf. Now, children, he is agrees to the Iron Master that he is Neil Oldorf and admits that this God knows down for him. Thinks he had gone down with me. He accepts that he knew him. So, children, that Iron Master, that rat trapper, he agrees with the Iron Master. And children, he admit himself as Niels Oldorf, and he is now a guilty conscious person. He accept that his that he himself, he told Iron Master that earlier he was not like that, but now a deep now nowadays he is looking like that. So he told Iron Master that earlier he was not like that, but now a deep nowadays he is looking like them. So now, children, see, now here Iron Master is inviting him to his house. He is thinking that he is his old comrade Neil Oloft, and this with this man he had worked in the army for so many years. That's why he's invited him to the party. But what is the condition in this second man is having? Now he's scared. He is thinking, he admitted first that he is Neil Armstrong, but he thinks, suppose if we can take him to the house, and suppose by any chance if he will come to know that now he is not his friend, then what he will do with him? Okay, so he admits that he is his friend, and fine, later on he told Iron Master that earlier he was not like, but nowadays he is looking like that. Nowadays he is looking like a army comrades. So both are confused. One is confused, the Iron Master, he is still wanted that he should get the good education in the world, though the whole he is thinking he should not have resigned from the regiment, and he is telling him that you should not have resigned from the regiment, said the Iron Master. That was a mistake. If only I had still been in the service at that time, it never would have happened. Now, children, that black the Iron Master is still thinking his old days. He is thinking that how nicely they were doing their work in the army, but he had resigned. He told ki, if I would have been in the place of my boss, I would never have let you do that. He did not want to undeceive him. That means he did not want that he should be deceived. He did. Now what happened? That gentleman, he went to his house as his old acquaintance. Okay. He might perhaps thrown him a couple of kroner, but therefore he did not want to understep him all at once. Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. Now he's telling that nowadays I'm a bit worried. I left the army, but even the God has not supported me. You should not have resigned from the regiment, said the iron master. So iron master told you should not have resigned from the regiment. That was a mistake. If only I had still been in the service at the time, it never would have happened. He told that if I would have been service at that time, if I would be a chairperson, I would never let you resign. So that iron master is still thinking that he is his friend, his comrade, but he knew very well that he is not his comrade. To go along up to the manor house and be received by the owner like an old regimental comrade, that however did not please the tramp. Now children, in fact, now that tramp slayer, he did not want to go to the major house. Okay, and he did not want that there he should be the horse. This time who will be the horse? That the master, that iron master. Okay, and that was a mistake. If only I had still been in the service at that time, it never would have happened. Well, now of course you will come home with me. So he is telling, you will come home with me. That means he is forcing him to come. He is not able to decide whether he should go or not, because he knew very well that he is not the man to whom he had been so kind, and he is inviting him. To go along up to the manor house and be received by the owner like an old regimental comrade, that however did not please the tramp. So he told that I want to go from this house, I want to do some work. Okay, so do go along up to the manor house and be received by the owner like an old regimental comrade, that however did not please the tramp. He did not actually like it, that why he is sending him to the house. Though he admits that he had told lie to him, he till now he did not disclose him that he is not Niels Ofstrom. But he is inviting to his house, and he had accepted the invitation, and he is going to the house. So this much we have done. No, I could not think of it, he said, looking quite alarmed. Now children, that rat trap seller, he is a bit surprised. He is thinking why he is of life, why he is forcing me to come into his house. So he could not think of it, why it has been done. Okay, he was looking quite alarmed. He thought of the 30 knot. To go up to the manor house would be like throwing himself voluntarily into the lion's den. Now children, so he had invited him to his house, but then he started thinking something else. He started thinking now he had having that stolen money with him. How much money he had stolen? 30 kroner. He knew that if he will go with that money to his house, he might be caught by the police. So he is avoiding now. He is avoiding now to go to his house. The iron master assumed that he felt embarrassed because of his miserable clothing. But children, that iron master thought that he is not coming to his house because of his clothing. Please don't think that I have such a fine home that you cannot show yourself there, he said, not in front of everybody, the Maharaja told. No, the Iron Master told him, please don't think that I have such a fine home that you cannot show yourself there. He's telling, I'm not inviting you in such a fine home, but it is there. Okay. He thought of the 13th to go up to the manor house, which would be like throwing himself voluntarily into the lion's den. He only wanted a chance to sleep here in the forge and then sneak away as inconspicuously as possible. So still in this part, now since I told you he did not want to go there, he was forced to go there. And why he was forced to go there? Because the Iron Master, he wanted that he should live in the big house which he was owning at that time. At that time his house was very big at the corner, and he was doing what? He felt embarrassed because of his miserable clothing. Okay, now this paragraph I will be explaining you afterward as your class duration is over now. It's 30 minutes. So then rest of the part I will explain you in the other videos. So with this, I bid you goodbye. Please go through the lesson. Please learn the new words, because you have to make use of this new word at the fullest. And with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day.